Hello and welcome to Wolves TV's coverage of the U23s against Southampton, coming to you from the Sir Jack Haywood training ground in Compton, Wolverhampton. This Monday lunchtime. We'll bring you the team news very shortly. Fabio Silva getting a run out from the first team once more as we wait the officials to make the short journey up the steps to the show pitch here at the Sir Jack Haywood training ground. You might be able to see in the background there former Wolves players Matt Murray and Lee Naylor here to see the action. That's how Wolves will line up today. Still no Lewis Richards, having picked up a knock just before the international break. Fabio Silva starts up top. Chem Campbell and Jack Hodnett will provide the support. Michael Agboola comes in from the start in defence, with Harry Birtwistle dropping to be amongst the substitutes. And a name to look out for in the Southampton lineup, Oladare Olafunwa, was the man who got the winning goal the last time these two sides met. A game which pretty much condemned Wolves to relegation from Premier League to Division 1 as they were in back in February of 2020. Both these teams only managed a couple more matches before the season was curtailed by COVID. It was a match where Jack Scott and Pascal Estrada were amongst those who made their under-23s debut on that occasion. They both remember not quite fondly. Jack Scott nearly scored on debut. It was an incredibly young Wolves team on that occasion. But Wolves went on to reach the Premier League 2 Division 2 playoffs last year. Southampton had another year of struggle, ended up finishing bottom of the division. And they didn't have a single win in their final 10 games of the campaign, including 8 defeats in a row to end the season. They haven't won in Premier League 2 Division 2 so far, meaning 17 games without a win at Premier League 2 level for the Saints. They are bottom of PL2 Division 2. And we'll be hoping to end that run against the old gold this lunchtime. So Fabio Silva to get us underway. Wolves having been held to a goalless draw against Aston Villa last time out. They were beaten by Shrewsbury in the EFL Trophy a couple of days later, but it was a much changed side. Couple of players away on international duty. J. Jack Scott dispossessed. The challenge of Agboola into the trees. First team do occasionally train on this pitch, though normally they would be the other side of those trees down below. Not in today. Oh, and an awkward pass back towards Louis Molden that I'm not sure he was expecting. And very early on, Southampton giving a bit of a boost with a fortuitous set piece. It's not quite switched on yet. There are difficult conditions. There's a lot of rain and wind swirling around. You see the branches and leaves fluttering behind as they get ready to deliver this corner. It's a high hanging delivery. And it was Olafunwa who climbed highest. It was from a set piece that he scored the goal that effectively condemned Wolves to relegation 2 years ago. Silva's flick on. Hesketh. Get it back from Fabio Silva. Kai Corbett was the man trying to make the run. You might remember watching him for Wolves earlier this season on trial. He'll join Saints as he looks to try and find himself a new club. Fabio Silva. Under pressure from Will Smallbone. Saints getting the benefit of the free kick. Here comes Fabio Silva looking for Kundal. Quite find his teammate. Semedo will clear. Agboola couldn't quite find Scott. Bit of a scrappy start from both teams so far. Goalkeeper is Jack Bycroft. It's Dario Olafunwa, Ollie Lancashire and Donnell Semedo. Saints back three. Number seven is Lewis Payne, who's chasing down Louis Molden. And he forced Molden to just play it out of play. Thierry Small is the left wing back. Keggs Chalk and Will Smallbone in midfield. Caleb Wadd and Kasima Legbe supporting Kai Corbett up top. This is Smallbone. Semedo for Small. Not a bad delivery in. Smallbone with a chance to reset. Heavy touch though from Watt. And Campbell. What a possession. Wolves with Molden in goal. Agboola, Estrada and Naya. Then Scott and Lembakisa are the wing-backs. Hesketh and Kundal in midfield. Hodnett, Fabio Silva and Campbell, the front three. Officially, Southampton don't refer to their this age group as an under 23 team. They refer to them as a B team. So pretty much the same thing. Molden clears forwards. Hesketh a little bit loose in midfield. Alegbe. Trying to pick out. It's a lovely run by Watt. And the pressure came in the end. And it will be a goal kick. Caleb Watt brilliantly played in by Kazim Alegbe. He might have pointed for a penalty, you know. Louis Molden is complaining. But Southampton have got themselves a spot kick. And it's Kasim Alegbe to step up in slightly controversial circumstances to give Saints an early lead. Alegbe against Maldon. And he finds the back of the net. It's a well-taken penalty. And Southampton are in front. Wolves furious at the awarding of the spot kick. But Alegbe made no mistake from the spot. It's Wolves 0, Southampton 1. Try and find a way to come back early in the game. So not the start that many were predicting. And Alegbe trying to cause some havoc again. Watt, this is Payne. Blocked by Lembakisa, but it's all Southampton at the moment. It's worth noting that Thomas Parsons, the referee, was also the referee who gave a slightly controversial penalty against Wolves in the 1-1 draw at Burnley earlier this season. There was some discussion between the referee and Jamie Pardington, who was the goalkeeper that day, in the tunnel downstairs before the game. And he's done it again. You can see the frustration on the face of Louis Maldon there. Caleb Watt gets set to try and deliver the ball in. Danger, and Maldon just about able to grab it. Wolves have not started well. Possession won back by Chalk again. Southampton are not playing like a team who haven't won for 17 matches. Bycroft forwards. Won't be too long for Corbett. Maldon to claim. Naya, calm enough under pressure. Holland's ball downfield. Fabio Silva couldn't win it. Condor, a good ball to find Lembakisa. Hesketh trying to, I'm not entirely sure what he was trying to do in the end. Put it back into an area. Found it hard going in the opening 9.5 minutes, Wolves. Might get something from this though. Hanging up, but maybe the wind just held it up a touch too much for Fabio Silva to get to it. Been put on Olafunwa. He's forced a loose pass. Condor couldn't hold on. Chalk. Corbett was chasing. Came off Jack Scott. just look a little bit more alert at the moment. It's a good header by Naya. Hesketh for Hodnett. Couldn't find Kundal. This time, Naya a little bit too eager to try and step in. They've got on with it quickly. Alegbe. Agboola getting back to him. There'll be a Southampton throw by the looks of things, although Wolves throw, Jack Scott to take. For a moment, like Michael Agboola had just held on to it for a touch too long. Strada with a little miscontrol. First came Lancashire. Condor. For Naya. Lembakisa. Naya. Now Kundal. For Estrada to try and pick out. Kundal looking for the feet of Fabio Silva. He's smiling for Smallbone. Lembakisa will continue his run. Has a bit of support. Might decide to go alone now. Lembakisa on again towards Chem Campbell. Big opportunity. Big save. The follow-up, but they still can't quite squeeze it in. And Chem Campbell offside. Well, what a chance. Brilliantly worked. And Dexter Lembakisa, following what Alegbe had done at the other end in just scooping a pass through, and Campbell maybe had to wait a touch too long. Bycroft seemed rooted to his line, but then made an important save. Wolves could and probably should be back on level terms. Best bit of play they've crafted so far. James Collins' team. Chem Campbell, who made one and scored one a couple of weeks ago in the win over Fulham. His only goal so far this season. He has talked about needing to add more goals. It's been generally improved all-round play in this campaign. Lembakisa. Oh, and Payne sliding in on Naya. This is Smallbone. Couldn't find the bottom corner. Sparing the blushes of Lembakisa and Naya on that occasion. On for Fabio Silva. Good run by the Portuguese. Scott. He had support from Hesketh, but he couldn't find him. Haven't got into a good position. Wolves may be guilty of just trying to overplay a touch. For what? To Payne. Campbell putting the pressure on. Payne's ball, Estrada intercepting. Hesketh wanted just maybe a second longer than he was going to be given. Fabio Silva's not giving this one up. Bycroft away. Here's a leg bay. Agboola getting back to him. Strong challenge from Michael Agboola. A loose pass again by Lembekisa. Payne infield to Caleb Watt. Neat and tidy from Southampton so far. They're making Wolves work. Very small forgot the ball and Hodnett will draw the foul. For Semeu. What with time to turn and space to run into. Trying to feed it in behind for Payne. It's got the better of Lembekisa. Well, the fun was delivery. Scott with the clearance. And it's just a bit scrappy defensively from Wolves so far. Mayu, a good ball for Payne. Dangerous low ball in, and Estrada just poking a toe at it. Southampton, much more fluid play so far. Feeling like they're in control. Looking the more threatening, go on and score next. Tough going in the opening 19 minutes. Silva hasn't seen much of the ball. Good chase here. Lancashire's clearance. Campbell's done well. Hesketh. Campbell continuing on his run. Scott. Hesketh trying to turn on the edge of the D. And a leg bait getting away from Agboola. And suddenly there are red and white shirts everywhere, and a leg bay went for glory. Well, from Wolves point of view, they're thankful that a leg bay was a touch selfish there. Had options either side. Small bone. Back from Semeu. Payne for Corbett. Oh, good block by Estrada. Important block from the Austrian. Connell a bit more space for Hodnett. On to Fabio Silva, who for the first time in the game saw an opportunity to have a go for goal. Had an important little cameo on Saturday off the bench as Wolves came back from two goals down. Win 3-2 at Villa. Not that anyone would need reminding of it, it just feels good to say it. Small for a leg bay. He's continued on his run here, Thierry Small, and nobody had gone with him. He was trying to pick out Caleb Watt. And it was Luke Cundall who got back. Oh, and a loose one by Scott. Pula with the block, but also just been uncharacteristically sloppy at times in the opening half of the first half, causing problems for themselves. If Southampton did come into this lacking in a bit of confidence, given their run of form, they've been very much boosted by the help that's been afforded to them. Caleb Watt's delivery. High, inviting. Wolves just about getting it clear. Small bone. Getting the better of Fabio Silva. Now Campbell. Hodnett, what a good ball. Here's Fabio Silva, bearing down on goal. Big opportunity. And in the end, Southampton got the numbers back there. Hodnett, Campbell. A bad delivery in. Cundall for Campbell. Then Bakisa on his outside. Campbell still going. And again, there was a foot in there to block. Southampton defending well. And two big possible opportunities. Just wonder whether Fabio Silva could have taken it cross on his left foot, used his body to block the defender coming towards him. Difficult when he maybe felt like he didn't quite have it in his legs to run away. For a moment, it looked like he was going to be clean through. Maybe just kick-started a better spell for Wolves, although that was a crunching challenge by Semedo and Jack Hodnett. Leg bay wide for Small. Oh, leg bay again. Straight into the arms of the waiting Louis Molden. Interesting and intriguing contest at the moment. Southampton in front from that early penalty. Kazima Legbe. It's a good challenge by Limba Kisa. Pesca. Not a lot ahead of him. You can see both he and Cundall waving teammates forwards. Hodnett for Scott. Abula, a little bit adventurous looking for Campbell. Always easy for Jack Bycroft to come out and claim. Oh, intercepted by Semayu. Got the better of the challenge with Agboola. Southampton recycling the play, trying to switch towards Lewis Payne. Naya just about got there, though it's dropped fortuitously. Leg bay to try and get it goalwards. Semayo down with a problem. Gets it back from Lancashire. And again from Payne. And again from Lancashire. Trying the big diagonal. Scott for Hodner. It was loose from Jack Hodner. Caleb Watt. Caught by Cundall on the turn. Deciding he'd already got his magic spray out. Magic vanishing spray. If you've got it, you may as well use it. Delivery. Side flag had gone up. Is that Bula? It's a good ball. Scott. Dealt with by Lancashire. First Wolves corner of the game. Taken 29 minutes. Champ Campbell. Feel like he should have equalised for Wolves. The best chance crafted so far. What can they make from this? Condall. Oh, big chance for Fabio Silva and surely poked home by Agboola. Wolves are claiming and protesting towards the officials. Nothing given. And a leg bay at the other end. Delivery in away by Lemba Kisa. Well, how did they not score there? Firstly, Fabio Silva's header, and then Agboola on the follow-up. He seemed convinced that it had gone over the line. From that kind of position, question whether he could have got it either side of Bycroft and taken away the need to look towards the officials. Credit to the Southampton goalkeeper. Wolves could not come closer to getting it back to one apiece. Clearly, some of them feel like they should be at 1-1. No goal line technology at Premier League 2 level. Certainly not at a training ground. They relied on the assistant referee on the far side to make that judgment call. That Agboola chance Chem Campbell's effort earlier on in the half. Should at least be level. Lemba Kisa managed to wriggle his way through. Too much on the cross for Fabio Silva. Jack Scott did well. Good run by Fabio Silva. Didn't pick out anyone in the penalty area. Scott will get another chance from the throw. That'll be a goal kick. Downfield. Maybe just feels like momentum has swung in Hall's favour last couple of minutes after a tricky opening period. Campbell's take advantage of that. Campbell, Lemba Kisa. It's going to come through here to Hodnett. Hodnett fancied a strike, well blocked by Semeu. Bula's header. Get the free kick. A couple of times already in this game, Wolves have shaped to shoot, found their route blocked. Kundal found his route blocked there, and Alegbe getting a yellow card. Kisa for Campbell. Naya. Estrada for Kundal. Lemba Kisa once more. Strong on either foot, Dexter Lemba Kisa. Campbell. Hesketh. Maybe tried one trick too many. Saints penalty area. Here's Kundal again, Fabio Silva calling for it. Very small header. Anywhere will do for Saints at the minute to get the ball clear. Maya holding off Corbett. It's one-way traffic at the moment. As Wolves try and find a way back into the game. Campbell. Just a little bit too much from Chem Campbell. Alegbe to Small. Alegbe again. Agbula back with him. Agbula. I think that ball had already gone out of play. So it was risky defending from Michael Agbula there. And playing it short to Jack Scott in an area where Wolves often do try and play out from defence, but times might be better off just getting the ball clear. Hodnett for Scott. Campbell in field of him. Hodnett here on the overlap. Campbell, Kundal. Back from Fabio Silva, now Lemba Kisa. Up against Payne. Lemba Kisa trying to deliver goal kick. A shame they had a couple of numbers in the penalty area there as well. Just fallen onto the ball, and quite rightly that is a Wolves free kick. Condal, Strada, Hodnett for Scott, oh, and a stumble. Had a busy international period, Jack Scott, away with Northern Ireland. They had a 1-0 defeat away in Russia. Traveled all the way to Moscow. To Spain. Small bone for Payne. And suddenly, oh, Legbe was in behind, and thankfully, it just kicked up off the turf. Corbett has found his route to goal, blocked off. For Lembekisa, should be a Wolves throw. The referee spotted something. Needs some attention. Conversation between Estrada and Corbett. They were wrestling with each other off the ball a moment or so ago. Potential teammates. Rivals for a matter of weeks. A little of loss between Pascal Estrada and Clyde Corbett. Sameu for Small. Caleb Watt, Corbett for Smallbone, Payne, Watt's continued on his run, Rafael Nye got across to him, Payne striking, and Bakisa, the man in the way. Throw Corbett. Smallbone going down and right on the edge of the area this time. So close to a second penalty of the game. Smallbone with the free kick, going for goal and a long way from it. Ball looking for Campbell. Smallbone, who's had plenty of control so far. to Watt, to Samayu. Southampton may well feel like they weathered the storm. They're coming back into it. And a really strong opening 25 minutes. Wolves then look to be getting to grips with things. They didn't get the goal. Even though Michael Agbula may well feel like it did go over the line. The officials disagreed. And it remains Wolves 0, Southampton 1. Of conditions, Wolves playing into a fairly strong breeze in this first half. Here comes Payne. Options either side. This is Olafunwa. Molden did well. Campbell deciding he's got the pace to get the better of Payne. Scott is forced further away and then loses possession a little bit too easily. Cross came Agbula to dispossess Thierry Small. Chalk gets it back from Watt. It's a nice turn from Caleb Watt. Old shirt swarming around him. Fun one. Playing back to Lancashire. Rain starting to fall heavier. Borders clearance. Straight to a red and white shirt. Caleb Watt. A leg bay. It's a Southampton free kick. Nelson Mayer involved in a shirt pulling on each other. Bit of a size difference, but Kundal wasn't backing down. Little small bone. On for Payne. It's a hanging delivery, thankfully. Nobody quite there in Agbula, and then Scott to clear. And Fabio Silva quite reached the through ball. He's having a few words with Samayo now. Plenty of frustration for those in gold. Tempers flaring a touch. There'll be plenty to talk about and work on at half-time for James Collins. How much Stonger. He'll use Fabio Silva today. What else he's got to try and work on? His side behind at the break. An early penalty. Slightly controversially given. And Caleb Watt was played in by Kazim Alegbe. It looked like he just got his shot away under pressure. But Thomas Parsons, the referee, who already this season had given a slightly controversial penalty against Wolves in the draw away at Burnley, pointed to the spot. And Alegbe dispatched it. Chem Campbell came close, as did Michael Agboola, who will feel like he should have got a goal. Was protesting to the officials that his effort had gone over the line, following up from Fabio Silva's header. But at half time, it's Wolves 0, Southampton 1 at the Sir Jack Haywood training ground here in Compton, sponsored by Fosun.
Thank you.
So welcome back, everybody, for the second half. A little bit of a delay to restarting. In fairness, Southampton are having to get changed in the academy building, which is some way away from where this match is being played. All part of the COVID protocols that they can't get changed in the regular academy dressing rooms that are at the closest end of the main building to where this pitch is. Those are being taken over by Wolves and the Wolves staff. Immediately, Lemba Kisa winning possession back. Wolves perhaps wanting to start strongly in this second period, as the Southampton did in the first. Molden in goal, Agboola, Estrada and Naya, the back three. Scott and Lemba Kisa, the wing-backs. Hesketh and Kundal in midfield. Hodnett, Fabio Silva and Campbell up top. And here is Hesketh with Lemba Kisa outside of him. Trying to fizz the delivery through. Quite wrap his foot round it. Jack Bycroft is the Southampton goalkeeper in blue. Back into the middle of your picture. Back three of Olafunwa, Lancashire and Semeyu. Payne and Small are the wing-backs. Smallbone and Chalk in midfield. Alegbe and Watt supporting. The trialist Kai Corbett up top. And he played for Wolves on trial earlier this season. And here's Jack Scott. Wasn't a bad delivery. And it might drop for Hodnett. Oh, and he got it all wrong at the key moment. Looked like he was going to be sitting there inviting for Jack Hodnett. He's always going to be on his weaker foot. Corbett for a leg bay. Now Payne, offside flag has gone up. Kisa advanced down that left-hand side. Hesketh's run. And Kisa, he fancied a go. Comfortable stop for Bycroft. Dexter Lemba Kisa is making the step up from the under-18s. Taking advantage of the injury to Lewis Richards to get a little bit more game time has been impressive in his under 23 appearances so far this season. Many found it tough going in the opening 25-30 minutes of this game. Molden, Scott's touch. This is Campbell. Hesketh. Here's Silva for Lemba Kisa. This ball will go harmlessly through. It's worth pointing out sometimes how difficult it can be when Fabio Silva dropping in for some much needed game time, but he won't have trained with some of these players at all. The builder, of course, would have been in the first team. Completely different schedule. Some of these players will train with the first team from time to time. That just adds to the difficulty of working on their tactical plans, getting the preparations just right. Small. Overhit the cross. Gone out of play. touch by Luke Connell. A leg back. Now for Corbett. Real power behind the effort. Drawing the free kick, and I think there's a card coming here. We'll double check for you, but it might have been Lewis Payne, but we will get confirmation of that in a moment or two, just off your right hand side of your picture. Short. Kisa for nine. Now a struck. It's small bone. Very small. All a fun one. On for Payne. Caleb Watts done well. Still continues to drive forwards and gets the better of Lemba Kisa, but Louis Moulton is there to claim it. Back the looked like Bula chance in the first half and half time. Did very much appear like the ball had gone over the line. Kisa looking for Fabio Silva. He got the flick on, but Campbell wasn't able to reach it. It's touched by our colleague Jack Walker, playing the ball back to Bycroft. Thank you. Smallbone to deliver. He's doing just enough. Campbell can't get away from Will Smallbone. Just hasn't been enough in the final third this afternoon. Remember Kisa. Their way out of a tight area. Corbett, see the rain getting heavier. Wind has been swirling around Compton all day, making things tricky. Silva's got rid of his shirt and gloves for the second half. Regretting that decision right about now. Here's Cundall. Foot in by Agboola. Silva couldn't capitalise. Danel Semeyer. Small on for Semeyer again. Flying in. Keeps coming. Smallbone's attempted kick. It's an infringement. In behind, Molden was alert to the danger. This is good play by Southampton. Strada sliding in, Molden will get hold of it. Silva, who challenged with Semeyu, and the system was flagging for a foul for Southampton. Fabio thought there had been something going his way. Quite
shot.
To Cham Campbell again. A bit heavy for Hesketh, who slides into keep hold of possession. Bundle caught with a sore one. Place Michael Agbula. To see whether this is a full change of formation. Imagine Jack Scott will eventually go in. Play on the right hand side of a back three if they stay that way. Looks maybe like just going to a back four. With Harkin and Campbell either side of Fabio Silva, and Hodnett maybe dropping back in. He and Hesketh then with Cundall a touch deeper in midfield. Wolves do have Harry Birtwistle amongst the substitutes, who's been playing right wing back this season. Of illness with the international break. It's a choice between he and Jack Scott to play at right wing back today. Scott having been away with Northern Ireland. Possession. Chalk. Did enough. Harkin. Silva lost his footing. Estrada. And Campbell. Strong run from Cham Campbell. In the end, ran out of room. Saw him a couple of weeks ago against Fulham. From a similar type area. Ended up leading to goal for Owen Hesketh. Capable. Hesketh, find Fabio Silva. A tough afternoon. Free kick and is. A yellow card coming for Thierry Small. He's not so small, Thierry. Only up against Lee Harkin. That's by Jack Scott. Leg bait. Jack Scott. Scott lost his footing. And Small has kept it in. Walden with the initial block. Danger not fully cleared, and Wolves just about getting the numbers back there to deal with it. And Fabio Silva now trying to release Harkin. Might need some support here. Was looking for Fabio Silva. Gone out of play already. Scott's delivery. Cleared away by Lancashire. A leg bait. And it back from Watt. Initially by Hesketh. Gets in the challenge again, Owen Hesketh. Campbell. So they're bouncing to the path of Lembekisa. Oh, Harkin. Round at the far post. Go down as an opportunity, one off target, a long way off target. Southampton just leading in terms of shots on target, 5-4 in this game. 2 off target as well. Say they've had a horrible run of form. It's James Collins trying to get some instructions to Pascal Estrada. Looks like Connor Carty is being prepared just behind them. Saints had a 1-1 draw with Stoke last time out. They had a run of 4 defeats in a row before then, losing away at Birmingham, home to Burnley, away at Fulham, and then also away at Middlesbrough. They had a 0-0 draw with Nottingham Forest and were beaten 3-0 at home by Norwich. They struggled last season in PL2 Division 2. They only won 4 games out of 24 last season, on their way to finishing bottom of Division 1 and being relegated. They used the second most players last year, 47 across the campaign. And there might be a double change, because that's Harry Birtwistle ready as well. So Fabio Silva's afternoon comes to an end. All likely have been predetermined that he would play 70 minutes. It's Jack Scott to be replaced by Harry Birtwistle. A little bit more pace, perhaps. Birtwistle, more of a forward-thinking wing-back than an actually defensive one. Changes. Lembekisa. He's done really well, Dexter Lembekisa. Cartier outmuscled by Lancashire. Leg bay fouled. Fouls in this game. Mike Corbett coming off. Romelo Mitchell coming on. Off the ball by Rafael Naya. Remember, Kisa losing possession in a dangerous area though. Naya with 1 foot in, Hodnett with the second. Chalk winning it back. Here, what for Thierry Small. Thought he'd spotted a gap. Leg Bay just lost his footing as he went for goal. Kick. Lost his footing. You can see how wet and greasy the surface has got down there as the rain has continued to pour. And these are pitches built on the very best drainage you can get. Giving it up. And the fun was header. Chalk getting the better of Hodnett. You need a big last quarter of an hour here, Wolves. Burt whistle. Looking for Harkin. Samayu. He shouldn't really have been able to get his way out. And four Wolves players around him, though. Thankfully, the loose pass gives possession back. Double turning. Sense of a bit more urgency for Wolves now. Campbell. Again, maybe just overdoing it a touch. Caleb Watt, filled to a leg bay. Whose first half penalty still separates the two. We'll come to Smallbone. Good block by Naya. Enough to play it around inside the open penalty area with no pressure. Harkin, Burt whistle. Hodnett. The adventurous side trying to find Chem Campbell's run. Payne has a problem. Put the ball out of play. For Lewis Payne is an opportunity for both benches to have some words, some bits of final encouragement for the final push. Was a touch hurried, rather challenging. Still back heel by Harkin, gets it from Birtwistle. And then over hits a cross meant for Colin Carty. Small is let Carty Birtwistle getting away from Josh Lett, still forcing his way through, and he just couldn't quite pick anybody out. Taking it short to Cundall. And now Heskett. Cundall again. Hodnett. That's nice footwork by Jack Hodnett, but didn't quite have the finish to follow it up. Watts ball, leg by giving chase, come a long way. Do they have it within them to produce a moment of quality late on in this game? Been behind for an awful long time, since the sixth minute. Tim Campbell had a glorious chance in the first half. Michael Agbula thought he'd got the ball over the line as Naya fouls Romelo Mitchell, and there'll be a yellow card. Rafael Naya. really crafted anything second half. Able to really utilise having Fabio Silva available for this one. A couple of times they've got into good areas and maybe been a touch guilty of overplaying it. Players learning their craft and sometimes making the wrong call and judgment. There's clearance under pressure from Bert Whistle. Chasing. A bit scrappy from both sides. Southampton potentially closing in on a first win in 18 Premier League 2 matches. Start to feel the nerves. Just have to keep going. Pressing to the last. That Caleb Watt's got the better of Condon. Now here comes Alegbe. It's on to Lewis Payne. And he could only find the waiting Louis Molden. Wolves can't afford to leave gaps. Find opportunities for Southampton to kill the game off. This is a run from Connor Carty. What are you really harking to aim for? And substitution. For Southampton, Caleb Watts coming off. Jaden Smith coming on. Find one more moment, one more opportunity, clear cut chance, so far eluded them. Might come here from Campbell, Carty slipping, comes to Harkin, oh, and a big save. Lembakisa then fires over. Well, we just questioned whether they were going to craft one more big opportunity. And they were almost queuing up. Carty lost his footing at the key moment. And Lee Harkin with a goal at his mercy. Denied by Jack Bycroft again. Campbell. McCarty. Hold on to it. Estrada. Bert Whistle. Nice footwork from Bert Whistle. Look to be pulled back by Josh Lett, who I think might get a yellow card, but we can't see. He was reaching into his pocket. I don't think the card was shown. We will check. Here's the spray. Campbell taking it short. Hesketh was the man who helped it in. Then Bakisa. Again, players losing their footing. Bakisa's high ball. Samayo's header away. Chalk to try and carry it forwards. Wolves doing enough to win it back. Harkin. Hesketh couldn't hold on. Small bone for a leg bay. We don't have any ball boys. I'll wait for Jack Bycroft to go and fetch that loose ball. Set back to Molden. One more minute of the 90 remaining. Jack has gone to play ball boy again. Playing his part to try and speed it up. Southampton look to see it through. Challenging with Cundall. Hodnett back to Bert Whistle. Won't be enough to lift Southampton off the bottom of the table, but it will close the gap to Sunderland. Campbell losing out on possession. Forwards. Holder needs to hurry. Hesketh couldn't find Hodnett, but Cundall rescues the situation. Lembakisa. Cundall on looking for Harkin. Wolves need to commit a few more bodies into that penalty area. Harkin's delivery, and it nearly was turned into his own net by Ollie Lancashire. Hesketh. Just too high for Rafa Nair. It will be another corner. Arkin taking responsibility. Bad delivery, or oh, Naya couldn't quite reach it. Lembakisa for Burt Whistle. Hesketh taking control. Condal looking for the run of Harkin. Oh, just too much on the pass. Day for James Collins team right from the start when they unnecessarily conceded a corner. Sorry, flag. He's against Jaden Smith. They'll look back on efforts for Chem Campbell and Michael Agbuda in the first half. Lee Harkin, especially in the second. There's chances that could have maybe should have been taken to get something from this game. Still time. Harkin's delivery. Couldn't pick anybody out. Final minute of the five being added on. Lembakisa. Again, couldn't find Carty. Strada looks to have stayed forwards now as Wolves go in search of a late equaliser. Onnet couldn't control. Chalk for a leg bay. Southampton maybe with an opportunity to seal it. Romelo Mitchell. Lewis Payne. Heading for the corner flag. And that's it. And relief for Southampton, who finally win for the first time in 18 Premier League 2 matches. Wolves beaten here at the Sir Jack Haywood training ground. Kazim Alegbe's early penalty, given in slightly controversial circumstances, the difference between the two teams. Wolves just never really looked like getting the efforts on goal they would need. Couple of good saves by Jack Bycroft, but not enough play in the final third to really test the Southampton defence, who themselves had had a couple of good chances too. It was more Wolves in the second half than the first. For all their possession, they weren't able to craft clear-cut chances until late on when Lee Harkin was denied. So James Collins' side are beaten, and we'll have plenty to think about and stew on as they prepare for their next action in Premier League 2. They have the long trip to Newcastle. 25th of the month up at the Northumberland FA ground. We will bring you that game live on Wolves TV as ever. Reaction to this one at Wolves Academy, wolves.co.uk. It finished Wolves 0, Southampton 1.